everyone. It's good to be with you again today. Today we are going to continue with our journey through the Old Testament with a story about the dividing of Israel into two kingdoms. But first, let's sing together.
From my head to my shoulders, my knees to my toes, I praise the Lord.
King Dave wouldn't let the giant stand in his way. He said, hand me my sling, 'cause he's not that tall. My God is bigger and I watch him fall. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Have you heard the one about this guy called Dan? Yes, he was a mighty holy praying man. They said, throw him to the den of the scary beasts. But God saved a hero from the lion's teeth. Yeah! My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. History, you will do the
same for me. Like Jonah and the whale at sea. When I'm lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. Oh, you're with me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of me.
Last week, our memory verse was James 1 verse 5. If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who will give it to you. Today, our memory verse is 1 Kings 11 verse 38. If you listen to what I tell you and follow my ways and do whatever I consider to be right, then I will always be with you. Please say that with me. 1 Kings 11 verse 38. If you listen to what I tell you and follow my ways and do whatever I consider to be right, then I will always be with you. Let's sing one more song together.
Jesus is my best friend, my best friend, my best friend. Jesus is my best friend. He's always there for me. Jesus is my best friend, my best friend, my best friend. Jesus is my best friend. He's always there for me. On Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, Jesus is my best friend. He's always there for me. Yeah. Jesus is my best friend, my best friend, my best friend. Jesus is my best friend. He's always there for me. On Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, Jesus is my best friend. He's always there for me. He's always there for me. He's always there for me.
Last time we learned about King Solomon. Does anyone remember who Solomon's father was? Yes, King David. When Solomon took over as king, God told Solomon that he could ask for one thing, and God would give it to him. Solomon asked to be wise, and God gave it to him. Do you remember what is wisdom? It is being smart enough to make a right decision and to do the right things that God wants us to do. Today we are going to have a look at what happened after King Solomon died. We read about this in 1 Kings 11 and 12. Please watch this video with me to see what happened.
Rehoboam and Jeroboam, the kingdom divides. King Solomon built the temple in Jerusalem for people to worship God. However, although God had told his people not to marry people from other nations who worshipped idols, Solomon married many foreign women, 700 of royal birth and 300 concubines. As Solomon grew old, his wives turned his heart after other gods, and his heart was not fully devoted to the Lord. On a hill east of Jerusalem, Solomon built a high place for Chemosh the god of Moab, and for Molech the god of the Ammonites. He allowed altars to be built for the gods of his wives, including Ashtoreth the goddess of the Sidonians. The Lord became angry with Solomon for turning away from him and offering sacrifices to idols. God told Solomon, "Since this is your attitude and you have not kept my commands, I will tear the kingdom away from you and give it to someone else. For the sake of your father David, this won't happen in your lifetime, but when your son takes the throne." When Solomon was rebuilding Fort Millo, he put a very able and hard-working man called Jeroboam in charge of the workers. One day as Jeroboam was leaving Jerusalem, the prophet Ahijah, who had put on a new robe, met him and spoke to him alone in a field. Ahijah tore his new robe into 12 pieces and said to Jeroboam, "Take 10 of these pieces, for God is going to tear the kingdom from Solomon and give 10 of the tribes to you. God will let Solomon reign for the rest of his life, but he will take away the kingdom from his son and give 10 of the tribes to you. Solomon has disobeyed God's laws and worshipped other gods. His son will rule in Jerusalem, but you will have power over the rest of Israel. If you obey God, he will bless you." Solomon saw Jeroboam as a threat and tried to assassinate him. But Jeroboam escaped and fled to Egypt, where King Shishak protected him. After a reign of 40 years, Solomon died and his son Rehoboam became king. Friends of Jeroboam got a message to him in Egypt to let him know that Solomon was dead. He returned in time for the coronation of King Rehoboam and immediately became the ringleader of those wanting to make demands on the new king. "Your father was a hard master," the protesters told Rehoboam. "We don't want you as our king unless you promise to treat us better than Solomon did." "Give me 3 days to think this over," Rehoboam replied. "Then, come back for my answer." After the people left, Rehoboam went to the old men who had advised his father Solomon. "What do you think I should do?" he asked them. "If you agree to be good to them and serve them well, you can be their king forever," they replied. But Rehoboam ignored their advice. Instead, he turned to the young men he had grown up with for their views. They said, "Tell them, if you think my father was harsh on you, well, I'll be harsher. My father used whips on you, but I'll use scorpions." So when Jeroboam and the people returned 3 days later, Rehoboam threatened them with even harder work and harsher treatment. When the people realized that the king was refusing to listen to them, they began shouting, "Down with David and all his relatives. Rehoboam can be king of his own family. Let's go home." As the prophet had foretold, 10 tribes deserted the king and only the tribes of Judah and Benjamin remained loyal. King Rehoboam sent an official called Hadoram to force the 10 rebellious tribes of Israel to work for him. But they responded by stoning Hadoram to death. When the news reached King Rehoboam, he jumped into his chariot and fled to Jerusalem. The 10 tribes summoned Jeroboam and made him their king. The nation of Israel was now divided, with King Rehoboam ruling over the tribe of Judah and Benjamin in Jerusalem and Jeroboam ruling the 10 remaining tribes of Israel from Shechem. King Rehoboam gathered an army of 180,000 fighters from Judah and Benjamin to force the rest of Israel to acknowledge him as their king. But God sent the prophet Shemaiah with the following message: "Tell Rehoboam and the people of Judah and Benjamin that they must not fight against their brothers. Tell them to disband and go home, for what has happened to Rehoboam is according to my wish." So the army went home as the Lord had commanded. Jeroboam thought, "Unless I'm careful, the people will want a descendant of David as their king. When they go to Jerusalem to offer sacrifices in the temple, they will become friendly with King Rehoboam. Then they will kill me and ask him to be their king instead." So on the advice of his counselors, the king had 2 golden calf idols made. He told the people, "Don't go to Jerusalem to worship. From now on, these will be your gods." One of the calf idols was placed in Bethel and the other in Dan. It was a disobedient act that displeased God. Jeroboam offered sacrifices on the altar to the calves at Bethel. He also made shrines on the hills and ordained priests who were not from the priestly tribe of Levi. Neither Jeroboam, or any of the kings of Israel that followed him, trusted in God or obeyed him. Eventually, many years later, God allowed the Assyrians to invade and take the 10 tribes away as captives in punishment for their constant disobedience.
What can we learn from today's Bible story? Rehoboam lost most of his kingdom because he listened to his friends instead of the wise, older people. This caused the people of Israel to fight and to split into 2 different groups. Jeroboam became the king of the new country of Israel, but he did not believe in the one true God. He made fake gods and set them up for the people to worship. Making good decisions is not easy, but it's very important that we follow the word of God and listen to what he wants us to do. If we follow our own ideas or that of our friends, we will make a big mistake. That can cause a lot of pain and a lot of problems. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we pray that you will help us to make good decisions that don't cause people to fight. We want to be united together in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's close this lesson with one more song, so please sing with me.
Heart, do not give up, pray it.
You can now do the activities that go with this lesson. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you all next week. Goodbye.